We need to know where we're at if we're going to move ahead. The stars are goals, and these blocks are obstacles. What we're going to draft out here, sort of, so I can get a picture in your mind, is styles of thinking. Now, number four thinker has a lot now, has a thinking process. Now, what is true is that all of us are all four thinkers sometimes in our life. That's what's true. What is important is where you are most of the time. That's what's important. Number four thinker. Number four thinker probably would not be in a seminar like this.
$350, right? For a seminar? For 4 days? For what? I got 12 years education school for nothing. I got all the candy education I got. I need. It ain't got me nothing.
Number four thinker knows that there are obstacles in life. Does not dream. Has no dreams. 9 to 5 or 8 to 4, 7 to 3, so whatever, right? Knows that he cannot have the dreams, so he doesn't dream. Been told, don't dream those dreams because you can't have them. Don't think that way because you're just going to, it's wishful thinking. Don't get to hoping that way because you're going to be disappointed. Poor advice. Because if we don't dream, we die. Nothing great ever happens without the dream. Everything begins with a dream. Number four thinker doesn't dream. He knows there are obstacles in life. He knows he cannot overcome them. Number three thinker is the one I relate to most. Boy, have I done this. This is called scrambled eggs for brains. I've done this. You got big dreams. Everybody has a dream, right? You have big dreams. You want to dream the dream. Glass of water, please. Right? But you know there are obstacles in life. There are problems in life. And you know that you want this dream so bad, but there are problems out there, there are obstacles. And the dream feels so good, you talk about the dream, you tell your friends about the dream. But if you encounter the obstacle, you may fail. If you try one time, right? You may fail, and then you can't have the dream anymore. So it's better to stay in a state of confusion. It's better to sit around and plan. It's better to talk about it forever. Just talk and just dream. Never take action. Never attack the problem. Never go after the dream. You might fail. Number two thinkers. I don't relate to these too well, but I've certainly seen a lot of them. A number three thinker has a dream, but he never gets the star. He never gets the dream. He goes through life in confusion and talk. Sort of like diarrhea of the mouth and constipation of the brain. How's that? Number two thinker, I got a lot of quickies here. It's very stimulating if you fall in love with me. Number two thinker has got a dream also, but he's extremely well educated. I do not mean college. I mean he's educated by the I Can't Society, the school of I Can'ts, you Can'ts. He knows all about the Can'ts. Knows every reason why you can't have the dream. Because he studied it, the problem. He's always studying the problem. He believes you have to know everything there is to know about the problem. And guess what he does with the problem? He makes the problem bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger. And bigger. It's called making a mountain out of a molehill. You heard it? He makes the problem so big, guess what? He can never have the dream. And he never gets the dream. Just knows about it. He's a virgin. Number one thinker, remember that one? Number one thinker is the only one who gets the dream. What's really great is that every one of you here, sometime or another, has been a number one thinker. Only number one thinkers get the goal. Notice that. They're the only ones that get the stars, the only ones that get the dreams. They go through the problem, not around it. They don't avoid it. They go through it. They handle the problem. They understand the problem. They get excited about the problem. I love the problems. You know why? I'll give you an example of why, right? The problems is what keeps you from getting your dream. You know what's good about that? It separates the deserving from the non-deserving. There ain't no free lunch. When we pay a price for something, we appreciate it more. Did you ever notice that? The more you pay for something, the more you appreciate it, the more you enjoy it. Isn't that exciting? So the more we pay for something, the more we enjoy it. I mean, I really believe that people who drive Cadillacs enjoy them a whole lot better than people who drive Pintos. The goals are exciting. We need to have the dreams. The obstacles are exciting also, the problems. They separate the deserving from the non-deserving. They put value to those dreams that we want. That makes them good. Makes them worthwhile.